Yo boys, what is going on? It is your boy Nick from Run the Foot Market. You guys absolutely love these videos and I love them too. For the first bit of FIFA, I think this team of the week investment videos are really relevant because there's always a lot of things to make with, you know, money to make with these cards early on. And I think it's really helpful and useful to kind of go in depth, talk about everything that's possible with some of these informs. And we have a new team of the week. So team of the week two is here, and I was supposed to bring you guys this video last night, but I was a little bit behind on getting some other uploads out. So I did not get it to you guys last night, which I do apologize for that. However, we are here, and I am here to bring you guys this video. So if you guys do enjoy it, drop a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below who is a player that you guys are going to be picking up from this team of the week. Just to give you guys a little quick head start on how these videos go, you know, the informs from last week that I told you guys we're going to go up out of packs are already up. Werner's already up. Cancelo's already up. I still have my discard informs right here. I picked up these guys for discard, and this guy Alvaro, I told you guys, was a discard inform that was a phenomenal player, and you've seen him literally go up a ton in price already. I bought him for 10,500 and he's already almost 20,000. I believe yesterday he was 16k. He's already 20,000 coins, Alvaro. So if you bought a ton of this guy at 10,000 coins, GG. I was more focused on getting some of those players who were getting a once to watch, and that was just my area of focus for last week's investments. But that was a great one, and I want to look at this today and talk to you guys in depth about these cards. Let me know again in the comments, who is your favorite team of the week investment from this team of the week? So we start off on the bench. I don't really like any of these kind of guys. You know, these are all discard informs. You guys can't go wrong. These guys are going to be their minimum price. You really can't go wrong with any of these players in the reserves here. I don't think you can go wrong, but they're going to be discards. So these are things that you guys can pick up and put in your clubs, but to be honest, they're not the best investment-wise or link-wise. I don't see a lot in them that I see in a lot of other players. But any of these five, it's fine to just pick up one and put it in your club if you do have spare change. I always say it like, if you have spare change, just pick them up and put them in your club, right? There's nothing wrong with that, right? Just picking up a few of them and putting them in your club never hurts anybody. So that's just what I'm saying with these. Move on to the bench, and this guy is a Brazilian striker who's an 81 rated. Now, he's going to be discard for sure. He is 10,000 coins, so you guys can get him for 10,000 coins. You could also invest in him for Lucas's player of the month. You've got a lot of Brazilian informs in this player of the month, in this team of the week. So there may be a chance that Lucas has an inform requirement tomorrow. I'm not 100% sure. What I will tell you is this, guys. All these discard informs of good nationalities are must-buys. You guys got to pick up one and put it in your club. It's such a safe investment this year, and it's always such a safe investment to do. You guys can see Alvaro from last week is already a big time. And you have to look at it like that. Like, it's like a little bit of a stock that you're putting into in your club, and it grows over time. So I think that is something that you guys got to start to look at a little bit more. Again, it could be used for Brazilian player of the month for Lucas. I'm not positive if that's a true reason, but it's possible. And you know, guys, just to put a time on a lot of these cards and when I think is going to be the time to buy, I think Friday with once the watch is being open and all that, I think you're going to see team of the weeks drop drastically in price. I think team of the weeks are going to get really, really low on Friday. So definitely stay tuned and look out on Friday for these cards to drop down in price. I definitely think that that's going to be a decent time to buy. This guy, again, is going to be a discard inform. Musa's interesting. Musa's actually probably not discard. He's probably a little bit over discard. Musa at discard is very favorable, and I like to buy. I think if you guys can get Musa at discard, it's very safe. I don't think you guys can go wrong getting Ahmed Musa at discard. This guy, for me, I like a lot because he's Argentinian. And come SBCs in a few months, I think that you're looking at this guy to be probably going up a little bit in value. Anybody with that top 5, top 10 nation in terms of popularity is going to be a great, great investment long term, in my opinion. I think you can't go wrong. So a guy like DePaul, for me, is a very, very, very safe, investment. This guy right here from Young Boys Sulejmani, I'm not really looking at this guy as an investment, but again, a lot of discard informs. Now, I wanted to talk about this guy. This guy is playing in the Ligue 1. He's in the first league, French league, and he's discard, right? This is a very, very safe investment, right? This guy has 84 pace, 76 defending, 80 physical, 80 dribbling. Like, this is a little similar, not the same as Alvaro last week, but a little similar. This reminds me of Alvaro from last week. If you guys don't remember that, Alvaro's already up to about 20,000 coins. He was discard at a point last week. This reminds me very, this is very similar to me of the likes of Alvaro last week. Kenny Lala is right now 10,000 coins already. So this would be a great pickup to go mass invest. He's a right back in the Ligue 1, which is kind of a lacking position. You know, it's not bad, and I think you got to look at it as that's actually a favorable investment and something you guys might want to look into as a right back and being French in the Ligue 1. It's definitely a decent look. It's not a bad look by any means. Zieler is very interesting as well. This guy is discard, and he's in the German first league, I believe. He's in the Bundesliga. And it's definitely a good look, right? He's an 82 rated, and he's a goalkeeper that's Germany. So he's gonna link well with a lot of players, in my opinion. So in terms of discard investing this week, I think Zieler and Lala are your looks. Wesley's got an outside shout in terms of that. Musa could go up because he's an OP super sub. As we move into the actual starting 11 of the team of the week, Petr Cech is already 15,000 coins. Petr Cech is an 84 rated keeper in the Premier League. And he's a little bit more usable than Xhaka, in my opinion. Xhaka was that 84 rated discard investment last week. I think you have to look at Cech as a decent investment this week for sure. He looks decent, right? 6'5". He doesn't look like a bad goalkeeper. I don't think a ton of people are going to use him. However, he's already 15,000 coins. So if you see him drop down to like 12, 11,000, this is a must pickup, right? This is something that at least just get one and put it in your club. That does not hurt at all to just get one. So I would look at definitely getting one for your guys' clubs. That's something that you guys got to definitely look into doing. So then we have Meunier as well. Thomas Meunier is a fantastic investment, in my opinion. Thomas Meunier is almost one of the best investments from this team of the week. And the reason why is because he's not only a right back. People like to use this guy at center mid. I used him as a super sub at center mid last year, and he was phenomenal. He's got a 4-star weak foot. He's 6'3". He's high. He's got the Mbappe link. That's big, man. This Mbappe link that Meunier has is definitely big time. Having an Mbappe link is so critical to a player's jump in value. I think you got to look at it like that. Like, he does link to Mbappe. He's got 83 sprint speed, 84 attacking positioning, 87 crossing, and the defending stats are great. The stamina is fantastic. He's right now, 50,000 coins around there. You got to look on Friday, guys. Friday is going to be a big buy time with these team of the weeks. People are going to be focused on buying the ones to watches. Team of the weeks are going to get backed a ton, and they're going to drop down in value because not a lot of people are going to actually have coins to buy. So I think Meunier on Friday is a buy. Matip is right now about 20,000 coins. Matip is one of my favorite investments from this team of the week. He's a 6'5" center back from the Premier League, and he plays for Liverpool. I think by the end of the week, this is going to be my investment. I'm going to be very, very looking into buying a lots of Matips. He's one of my favorite investors from this team of the week, and I think out of packs, he's one of the safest team of the week investments. He's a Premier League center back with these statistics playing for Liverpool. I don't think he can go wrong with a guy like Matip, especially buying him out of packs. He's 20,000 coins. I think you try to get him at 15 or 16 by the weekends, and that's a great, great pickup. Then we've got Lucas Hernandez, who's actually a fantastic card. I've been saying this. He's a good investment as long as he's cheaper than Umtiti and Varane, and right now he already is. I think at about 60,000 coins, 60, 50, 55, 70, somewhere in that range, Lucas Hernandez is going to be a fantastic investment. He's got 81 acceleration, 86 sprint speed, 72 agility, 87 heading accuracy, 85 interceptions. Like, this card is fantastic. This is such a good card. Medium high work rates, and he's got a position change, right? I always like position changes. This guy's position changed to a center back from a left back, so you have to appreciate that as an investment. You have to appreciate the fact that he's been moved around a little bit. So it's a very, very usable, and I think it's more of less than a usable card. I think it's appealing to the eye. I think people like to go and try position change cards and try new cards and teams. So I think you have to look at it like that. Then we've got Lucas Leiva, who is he is right now about 20,000 coins, and he's an 85 rated CDM from the Serie A. It's not the Calcio anymore. Medium high work rates, 5'10". Definitely a solid card. I think if you see him drop down to like 17, 16, it's too cheap for an 85 rated inform with those decent statistics. You got to pick it up. Gundogan's going to be a killer investment this week. He's already 70,000 coins. These kind of midfielders this year are playing very well. These kind of midfielders are playing beautiful. And I think you should expect Gundogan to definitely rise up out of packs. Don't know necessarily yet what time the buy is going to be. It's Thursday when I record this video for you guys right now. 70,000 coins is his price. I think you got to look at 50,000 and then it's go time, right? It's a good card. It's definitely a card that is going to do you well this year, do you a solid. He's got good statistics, right? It's not the only statistic that lets him down really is going to be the stamina and the acceleration. Other than that, it's decent. The strength holds up. We've got Mr. Traore here, who's already like 12,000 coins. Does he still have the weak foot? He still has the one-star weak foot. And for that, I would say that Traore for me is just never going to be investable. Any player with a one-star weak foot for me, I'm going to always tell you guys no. Stay the hell away. I don't like a one-star weak foot at all. It doesn't do well for anybody. We've got Anderson Talisca, who's already somehow 30,000 coins on the market. I've heard this card is fantastic. He's 4-star, 4-star. He's 6'3". He's a Brazilian playing in the Chinese League. This is a great, great card on paper. The only thing that's bad about it is the balance. But other than that, he's got good finishing, decent composure, good long shots, good acceleration. You guys just got to remember, right? He's 6'3". This is a big boy card, right? This guy is going to be a big, big cam. So you have to look at Anderson Talisca as being a decent investment this week for sure. I don't think you can count this out as being a good investment. I just don't think that there's a way that you can sit here and say, wow, Talisca's not a good investment. I really like this team of the week. I think it's got a lot of gems as investments, guys. I think you guys got to look at it. And we'll do a review at the end of my favorites, We always do my favorites at the end of the video, but I like the team of the week for sure. You've got Insigne right now is about 150K. Look, Insigne doesn't have the best statistics this year. Three-star weak foot, but I've heard he's ridiculous in-game. I don't know if I love this as an investment. It's not one of my favorites because I don't think it's that desirable, but it's a good card. It's a three-star weak foot. He's got 95 acceleration, 86 sprint speed, 85 attacking positioning, 95 agility, 94 balance. So you've got a lot of things going with that card that are good. Ben Yedder is phenomenal. Five-star weak foot, four-star skills, high work rates, 5'7". This guy is ridiculous. 94 agility, 90 acceleration, 85 sprint speed, 91 jumping, 88 finishing with 87 composure. Like, Ben Yedder this year is absolutely ridiculous. Look, 92,000 coins for Ben Yedder is what you guys can pick him up for. It's crazy. Like, this card is literally insane. I don't know what to tell you guys. This guy is ridiculous. On paper, this is one of the best investments that you guys can make from this team of the week. I can't even believe that he's still... I'm surprised he's under 100,000. I think it's because he's an 84 rated. I think if you were to mass invest this card, it's probably 60 to 65,000 is the buy price. He's French playing in La Liga, so he's playing in a major league. And he's got a fantastic card. This is just such a good card. I'm telling you right now, this is going to be the killer investment for this team of the week. And then this guy's discard. So you've got another discard investment. So, talking about my favorites from this team of the week. Favorites from this team of the week for me is Mounier, Ben Yedder, Talisca, Matip, Hernandez, Cech, and then you get the discard informed investments. The one that I think I've grown to like the most in this team of the week as an investment is Joel Matip. This guy is a Premier League center back, which is a position this year that honestly, you've got Davinson Sanchez, Bayern, Van Dijk, and then after that, there's not many. I like this. I think the Premier League is extremely popular this year. I think a lot of people are using Liverpool squads. A lot of people have these Liverpool players they're buying up. I think Matip, if you can get him at like 15 or 14K, I think right now if you go on the market, Matip is probably closer to 20. It's insane. I think if you could mass invest this card at 15K, like there is literally no way you guys can go wrong buying this card at 15,000 coins. I think that this is such a good investment. I'm actually crazy about Matip this week. I like Ben Yedder. I think at 60K, it might be a little riskier getting in with a Ben Yedder. I think Talisca's a little bit not risky as well because he's such a good Brazilian cam. I don't think the Chinese League matters with that kind of player because he's Brazilian. I think he'll be in squads because he's Brazilian, not because he's in the Chinese League. And then I think you got to look at Mounier. I think Mounier is like, I made a lot of coins of Mounier last year. Mounier dropped down to about 35,000 coins at one point during the team of the week. And then I ended up selling up about 50 in the 50s, I think. So Mounier was about 10 to 15,000 coins a card last year. And it's a very good card. I think at 6'3", a lot of people are going to attempt to get Mounier in their teams as a right back. I think you're going to see it. So I wouldn't be surprised if Mounier ends up being one of the most popular investments from this team of the week. But Matip for me, guys, Matip is my favorite. I mean, I'm speaking about it. Last week, my favorite was Alvaro and Werner. This week, it's got to be for me. It's probably just Matip. I look at Matip as being ridiculous. It's probably Matip and Mounier. I don't like investing outside of the Premier League that much, but Mounier for me looks like a fantastic card, and I think it's a guy that a lot of people are going to use. I do. I think a lot of people are using Mbappe. I think a lot of people are going to try to fit Mounier in their team. It's just something that I think you're going to see. He's also got a four-star weak foot, and just being 6'3" helps so much. So, yeah, Matip for me is my favorite. He's already 20,000 coins, and come tomorrow, you're going to have a mass supply coming onto the market because of OTW. You might have a 2 or 3 hour period where these cards are going to drop very, 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 very low. Very low. I'm talking like big-time low, guys. So I would say to you guys, stick around, see if you guys can pick up any of these team of the week cards for a good price on Friday. It could be worthwhile getting a good investment. You may have a period where Cech and Matip drop down to discard. I'm not joking. They may drop down to discard, so they may get like 12, 13, 14,000, and if you guys see that price, you guys better go ahead and buy. Let me know in the comments down below who's your favorite investment from this team of the week. I think this team of the week is full of investments. I think you've got at least like 6 to 10 investments you guys can make from this team of the week. A few more than team of the week one, so I think it's very worthwhile looking into some of these guys. Let me know again, guys, in the comments. I want to talk to you guys. I want to feel you guys and hear what you guys are saying about this team of the week. You guys heard from me. Matip is probably the favorite for me. I think you got to look at Lucas Hernandez. That's a position change. You got to respect position changes. Mounier, Talisca, not bad. Gundogan, not bad. I probably want to rock out with Insigne. I'm not really liking the higher rated team of the week investments. I think it's better to just mass invest a lower down team of the week. And so, yes, boys, thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you guys enjoy the Team of the Week investment video. Stay tuned for the uploads on the channel. They're going to keep coming. And thank you guys for watching the video. I'll see you in a video soon. Peace out.